Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. This is Vikram and that is the Kia Seltos HTX IVT. As you can see, we have lot of LEDs, LED headlamps, LED turn indicators, LED DRLs and the fog lamp which is placed over here is also an LED. And you can see the piano black finishing over the front grille, which looks beautiful. It has that bold look because of the tiger nose grille which all Kia cars have, traditional Kia design language. And you can see these black elements just to reduce the visual bulk of the car. And coming to the side, the tire size happens to be 215/60R17. These are 17 inch tires. And you can see the turn indicators are mounted over the ORVMs and no request sensor on the passenger's door. On the driver's door we have request sensor, which you can see right now. And these roof rails are not functional whatsoever. And now coming to the rear tire size is also the same, 215/60R17. And we have discs in the front as well as in the rear, and it's got ABS, which I'll talk about while driving. As you can see, it has that floating roof sort of treatment because of these blackened out A, B and C pillars. We have a D pillar as well, which is finished in chrome. And now coming to the rear looks very nice. And as you can see, we have reflectors over here and the rear bumper is completely blackened out in order to reduce the visual bulk of the car, and Seltos written over there. As you can see, on the right fender we have IVT badging, which means intelligent variable transmission, which is nothing but CVT, Kia's CVT rather. And here we have the rear parking camera and a shark fin antenna over here, which looks beautiful. Here we have a request sensor for boot. And this is a 433-liter boot, which can be increased by the 60-40 split of the rear seats. And this one doesn't have electronic tailgate opener, which MG cars have. As you can see, the design looks very nice from the side. I'm a big fan of Kia designs, man. Even the Sonet. And this one is even more beautiful than the Sonet. Now let's get into the rear seat of the car. As you can see, there's no request sensor, which is obviously not expected at this price point. And these manual adjustable sunblinds are very, very functional. And as you can see, this soft touch materials, leather sort of material on the door feels very premium. And this door pocket can hold a 1-liter bottle. As you can see, the rear seat is very comfortable and the leg room, knee room and head room are not at all issues, even for tall passengers. And we have three adjustable headrests in the rear so that three people will be comfortable for sure. And the cabin is also very wide to accommodate three people. But the only thing is this middle backrest protrudes a little bit forward, which might be a little discomfortable, but for children, it's perfect. As you can see, the rear center armrest gets twin cup holders. And the cabin is quite airy because the window area is large enough and the cabin is spacious, and because of this beige or pale sort of treatment, the cabin is very airy. As you can see, we have rear AC vents and USB charging socket over here and a small storage space. And there's no hump in the rear, so it's a perfect place for three people. The seat back is slightly scooped out in order to increase the leg room and knee room. So guys, now let's get into the driver's seat of the car. In order to get in, we have a request sensor on the door handle. As you can see, the front door also has this soft touch material treatment, and this black treatment over here makes it look very, very premium. And it has a door pocket which is similar to the rear one. And these are the controls for the power windows, and this is to child lock the power window, and these are to lock and unlock the cars, and these are the switches for the ORVMs, as you can see. And here we have the headlight leveler, and this is to increase and decrease the illumination of the headlamp. And this is the start engine stop button, as we all know. Steering looks very sporty because of this flat bottom treatment and Seltos written on this. It's a very sporty steering wheel, and it offers a great feel and feedback while driving, which I'll talk about later. And on the left side we have controls for that infotainment system, and on the right we have controls for the cruise control. And now coming into this front center armrest has a storage space below it, and here we have twin cup holders, manual handbrake, and this is the gear selector of the car. And this button, which you can see over here, is for the driver's rear view monitor. And this car doesn't have wireless charging pad, which we can see on the GT line, but it has a 12 volt charging socket and twin USB sockets beside it. And this is a single zone automatic climate control AC, which chills the cabin in no time at all. In spite of a big cabin, this AC does a good job. This is a 10.25 inch infotainment system, which has Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation and everything. But this car doesn't have 360 degree parking camera and front parking sensors, which we have on the GT line and other higher trims. Cabin feels very premium, and these soft touch materials used on the dashboard makes it look even more premium. And my favorite part is this steering wheel. And now coming to the instrument cluster, we have a dual pod instrument cluster with a small MID in the center. And this MID has a lot of information like gear position indicator, temperature, odometer, trip meters and all. And this IRVM over here has an auto dimming function. And I forgot to show you one more cool feature of this car. It's the sunroof. Actually, the sunroof should be opened manually and then the sunroof. In order to open it further, you need to press it again. So guys, this is about the interior and exterior of the Kia Seltos. Without any delay, let's get driving. So guys, I am driving the Kia Seltos IVT, which is nothing but intelligent variable transmission, which can also be known as CVT. This is not the same CVT which we have been seeing in Honda and Toyota cars since a very long time. This is much more better than what we have on the Honda City and the Civic, because the CVT gearbox which is there on the Honda City robs away all the VTEC performance, but this one has a very good punch lower down. And this car runs on a 1.5 liter 4 cylinder naturally aspirated petrol engine, which produces 115 bhp of power at 6000 rpm and 144 newton meters of torque at 4500 rpm. The performance is very nice. In spite of IVT gearbox, it has a very good performance. The engine is punchy, and in the city it feels very nice, and the power delivery is linear, car is composed, and everything is very nice. And now coming to the steering wheel, this is a very light steering wheel when you're in lower speeds, but once you start pushing the car hard and fast, the steering weighs up decently well, and it gives you a very good feel and feedback. And turning this car is also very easy. It's a 4 meter plus car. This car, in spite of being more than 4 meters, it has a very light steering wheel, which makes it easy. Once you get into higher speeds, the car remains stable because of stiff suspension. Stiff in the sense, it is like in 60-40 ratio, 60% stiff, 40% light, which gives you a very good high speed stability as such. This 7-speed gearbox gives you smooth shifts, which you don't even realize that it gave you an upshift or a downshift. If you want to drive it in manual mode, all you have to do is slot the gear lever towards the driver's side, that is, then it gets into sports mode, and thereby you can control the gears by Triptronic function. There are no steering mounted paddles as such, and the brakes, it has ABS with EBD, which gives you a very good stopping power. It has discs on all the four wheels, and we have 17 inch wheels, so the brake
braking is very nice. The grip is also very good. The car remains glued to the road all the time. As you can see, the overtaking is also very easy. In spite of CVT gearbox, rather IVT gearbox, overtaking is very, very easy because it gives you immediate power. Now coming to the driver's rear view monitor, which can be activated by pressing a button which I have shown you previously. This rear parking camera can be activated during forward driving as well, which is known as driver's rear view monitor. But the resolution of the camera is not that good, but when you're in regular drive mode, it upshifts somewhere around 1500 to 2000 RPM. It upshifts in between 1500 to 2000 RPM. When you take manual control over things, you can rev it all the way till 4500 RPM. Now coming to the fuel economy, in city it returns somewhere around 14 to 15 km per liter, and out on highway it gives you 17 and sometimes more than that. In spite of petrol automatic, 17 is a very good mileage, and the driving position is also very nice. The seat is very comfortable, rear seats are also very comfortable, the steering is nice to hold on to. It gives you a good feel and feedback. Before shooting this review, I have googled some of the questions which are most asked about the Kia Seltos, and I think I answered almost everything. If you're left with any questions, leave them in the comment section below. So guys, this is the end of this vlog. If you like it, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video real soon.